Okay, moving to another topic. Yesterday at the UN, the Israeli Prime Minister Netanyahu denounced you as a Holocaust denier, and he held up blueprints of Auschwitz, blueprints as evidence of the Nazi effort to exterminate the law. If I may get personal for a moment, normally I don't. I'm Jewish. I have had relatives, cousins, that were killed. How can you deny what is an obvious fact?
Do you want me to speak about it?
Yeah.
You really would like me to speak about it?
Of course.
What my understanding of the Holocaust is the need to raise a number of questions, and I actually have raised those questions, but unfortunately my words have been distorted by the media and sort of a new form of information has replaced what were the very questions that I first initially raised, and then they call it information or the free flow of information. As a university professor, I had in my own mind several questions that I spoke out loud about, and I thought everybody has the right to ask questions. Isn't that the case?
So what?
I mean, do you think raising a question is a crime?
What's the question?
I'll tell you the questions on my mind again. I'm saying, if the Holocaust happened, should we not be asking ourselves where it happened? Isn't it the case that it took place in Europe?
Of course.
Who were the perpetrators?
The Germans.
So what role did the Palestinian people play in what happened?
Wait a minute. That's another subject.
Let me get a break.
I understand. Let me get. I'll get right back with that. Don't go away. We're back with the president of Iran. Right, we can discuss the Palestinian. I understand that point. Are you saying, though, are you denying that a Holocaust existed? Will you acknowledge here tonight that there was a Holocaust, that 6 million Jews were exterminated by the Germans? That's all I'm asking. We'll get to the Palestinian issue in a minute. Are you denying that?
I am an academic. I don't speak like a journalist. And I do not wish to speak non-academically. What I have in my mind is an academic question. So if you can bear with me and listen to these questions, welcome any answers you can give me. If you can't answer my questions, I'll really welcome any other person who wants to answer the question. Unless we answer the question, I can't be convinced. So the question was, where did it take place? You said in Europe. I said, who were the perpetrators? And you said Germans. And my third question is, what was the crime committed by the Palestinians to be forced to sort of be punished as a result of very well said, excellent.
But my question was,
establishing a Zionist regime, using the Holocaust as an excuse. I mean, that is what happened because the Holocaust happened, they said, and the Jewish people were oppressed, then the Jewish people need an independent government, and where then the war in Palestine? And we're saying, well, what exactly does this have to do with Palestine?
But I understand that intellectually, but the question, there was one simple question that you can clear up, and then we can discuss where the Zionist state was established. Do you agree there was a Holocaust?
Allow me to raise the second question and you'll get your answer. You'll have your answer then if you bear with me. Now, as for the second part of my question, now, there are many historical events. Many things have happened in it throughout history. Throughout World War II, 60 million people were killed. They all matter. They were all human beings. We have to respect each and every life that was lost in the course of the Second World War. Now, if the Holocaust is indeed a historical event, why is it that politicians care so much about it? Usually politicians allow me.
Do you
usually politicians do not give so much attention to historical events. So my question is, exactly what result was to be derived of the event that happened that made it so important? How did it influence what we see today? I mean, what is the connection between this event and what goes on in the world right now?
Let me get a break.
Some people are biased, and you have to allow me.
I know, but I've got a time commitment here. It's crazy. We'll be right back. Couple of other areas I want to cover, so the next time we'll get to this in full discussion.
But we have to finish this discussion on this topic.
But
you have to give me a minute on
this. I know what you're saying.
I mean,
you said it last
remember,
time.
You cannot violate the rights of the audience.
I understand it, but all I wanted to know is, do you agree that there was a Holocaust? That's a simple yes or no. Do you agree that there was a Holocaust?
Allow me. If you bear with me,
was there a Holocaust?
You want to impose your viewpoint on me?
No, it's not a viewpoint, it's a question.
Why do you want to impose your opinion on me? It doesn't work that way. Right now in Europe, there are historians, scholars who have differences of opinion on the subject of the Holocaust. I'm not a historian. I leave that alone. I am focused on the result of all that on our lives today. I'm not a historian otherwise. All I can see is that a historical event is being used in order to carry out genocide in Palestine, and I'm opposed to genocide.
It's
genocide that I'm opposed to.
I gotta get another break.
So why is it that the Palestinian people should be subjected to genocide?
I understand
that
all
question.
That, and you make that point.
That's the question. So, okay,
I only
a lot of things have happened in history, and
you
don't.
You can share that one viewpoint and not be a denier. Okay. Right. I got to get to another subject.
If the European governments allow historians and scholars to freely engage in research that involves the event and discuss all their points of differences and come to a consensus and tell everyone what they think, that would be a great step. But unfortunately, even when a member of parliament sort of says something that goes against the common
Mr. Netanyahu didn't prove it to you yesterday. We'll be right back. More moments. Don't go away.